although today's session is unplanned, but it can be a very historical session as it will be taken from an altogether different perspective. Today's session is on A to Z of Bhakti, not A to Z. A to Z is still Gopi Bhav, till Gopi Bhav, but not till Manjari. A to Z means Bhakti ends at Manjari Bhav, highest Bhakti. So as we all know that when the spiritual merits of a Jiva gets amassed and fructify, he is blessed with a special Kripa. That is association of devotees, the highest Kripa. Normally a Jiva is engaged in performing either good or bad activities, and as per his karmas, he gets associated with different people. But when he is really blessed with the special Bhagavat Kripa, then he is given the opportunity to have close association of the devotees. When granted with this opportunity, he is able to understand that I should not be engaged in performing either good or bad activities, because with the performance of either of these, I will remain still caught up in the cycle of birth and death. Slowly, slowly, gradually, when he gets the association of genuine devotees of the Lord, he is able to understand that beyond this material world, there exists another world known as Vaikuntha Loka. There are innumerable Vaikuntha Lokas in which Vishnu Tattva resides. And the fountainhead, the Anshi of all these is Lord Shri Krishna himself in Goloka. Thus when one receives all this knowledge, he first thinks, desires to just get liberation from the cycle of birth and death. But when the complete transcendental knowledge is bestowed, the conclusions are known, then he thinks that simply by getting liberated from the cycle of birth and death, then that desire to achieve Sri Krishna develops within him. Otherwise, only the desire to achieve the Lord Bhagavat Prapti was there. But when one hears about Sri Krishna and his Dhamma, Braj Dhamma, one wishes, can I also attain Sri Krishna? Earlier, when devotee used to hear about Lord, then it was said that one can become Lord's servant. But when we are blessed with further Harikatha, when we get to know that not only in Dasya Bhav, other Bhavs also, relationship with Krishna is possible. Like Sakha Bhav, in which he plays with Dugwal Balas, and when he loses a game, the Gwalba sits on his back, the back of the Supreme Lord, and they kick him on his belt. Oh, move fast. Then astonishingly, the devotee thinks, oh, is this possible with the Lord, such a relationship? Then when we hear that Lord has wives also, who order him, oh, go bring Parijat flower. And Lord fights with big demigods for that. The sadhaka thinks, is this possible for people like me? We find that all those who have practiced various tapasyas, austerities, have got the opportunity to become wife of the Lord. That desire develops in the heart. Can this also happen to me? As we hear about the other higher leelas, that Lord, though cannot be tied down by anyone, but Mother Yashoda in Damodar Leela binds the Lord with the rope of her love, the parental affection. This mood of Vatsalya is on the fourth rank. Fifth and the highest, the mood of Kanta Bhava, the conjugal love, the Gopi Bhava. We read in scriptures that the personified form of Vedas, the Shrutis, practiced the required austerities to attain this gopi bhava. We finally thus realize that to attain the mood of the gopis is the highest. If someone can, it means that I can also attain it. Yes, I can also. We also find that even Goddess Lakshmi Devi desired to become a gopi. Thus, it means that this wish desire can be made and it is fulfilled also, provided the required practice, the required sadhana is done to attain that. If the required sadhana practice is not done properly, then the goal cannot be accomplished. As per the scriptures, we see the personified form of Vedas properly performed sadhana and successfully became the Braj Gopis. But on the other hand, Lakshmi Devi, though desiring to become a Braj Gopi, did not do under allegiance of Braj Gopis, did not do the right sadhana. So, was not able to become a gopi. To have desire for something and to perform the regular required practice to attain that goal is a different subject altogether. They're two different subjects. Sometimes one more thing is also possible, not to have a desire for it. If the desire is not there, then nothing can be achieved. Mahaprabhu himself said, Sadhan bina sadhe vastu kabu nahi paaye. Without performing sadhana, the siddhi cannot be achieved. As we all got to know that above Vaikunth Lok exists Golok Dham, in which Krishna is served in various bhavas. One can have relationship with Krishna in any of those bhavas. By hearing that, the desire to serve Krishna in the most confidential form develops. And we begin to lovingly chant Maha Mantra. O Shri Krishna, please engage me in your service. Radharani, please engage me in your service. Please give me a darshan. If asked, what all time do you want, you are? Huh? Tapomaya. What all, Tapomaya Das, you want to be engaged in service of the Lord, what all times do you want to be engaged? At whatever time, one will ask, the Lord will engage him in all those times. If one is praying to Krishna, simply engage him in his service. He can engage him by making him either a gopi or a sakha. But we will pray for that bhava. Only then he will engage. But we don't pray for that bhava. We wish to serve. The Gaudiya Vaishnava wish to serve in conjugal bhava. Although through scriptures we understand that the personified form of Vedas by performing required practice became Braj Gopis, we hardly find the secrets of Manjari bhava in the scriptures. In Shastras, though Manjari bhava is there, but in a very secretive, confidential form. The mysteries of Manjari Bhava are present in Granthas described by six Goswamis. These Goswamis are the chief Manjaris, prime Manjaris. They are the best persons to tell about themselves, the Manjaris. Therefore, who are the prime Acharyas for Gaudiya Vaishnavas? The six Goswamis and no one else. Only one Prabhupada, Srila Rupa Goswami Prabhupada. Thus we take shelter of Rupa Goswami Prabhupada. Why? Because he himself is a Manjari. Goswamis themselves are prime chief Manjaris. One can attain the goal only when one does bhajan, the right sadhana, by taking shelter, anugatya, of these Shat Goswamis. A surrendered life is the very life of a practicing devotee. Without surrendering, nothing can be accomplished. Thus for us, the Gaudiya Vaishnavas chanting Hare Krishna, Manjari Bhava Sadhakas, the prime Acharyas are the six Goswamis. We recite Harinam, praying, Shri Shri Radha Madhav, please engage me in your service. But now, as we got to know that there are many services which even Lalita Vishakha Sakhis cannot perform, then the question arises that I am praying to be engaged in service, but Lalita Vishakha also cannot do certain services, but they are rendered by someone else, and they get much more relishment than even Lalita and Vishakha. Till now we knew that only the gopis have the highest possible relationship with the Lord. But now we got to know that no, Manjari's relish much more, much confidential relationship with Shri Krishna and Radharani. Then while chanting Hari Nam, we pray, Almighty Shri Shri Radha Madhav, please engage me in your service, and that too 24 hours, please engage me in your loving service. Even in those services also, when Shri Shri Radha Krishna are engrossed in Vilas, even at that time also, we wish to serve them. At that time, the Sakhis, Lalita Vishakha, cannot render service, nor can the Sakhas. And there is not even a slight tinge of fragrance of this mood, in the mood of parental affection. Then we realize actually that Manjari Bhav is the topmost, the supreme. Okay, this mood is the highest of all. The relishment of Manjaris is higher than any other devotee of the Lord. Even the sadhanas, the devotees who get siddhas after doing sadhana, their relishment is much higher than Nanda Yashoda, the eternal associates, nitya siddh associates of the Lord. We find in Vedas that since time immemorial, gopis exist, and even at the time of Lord Rama, who was very much attractive in the Dandakaranya forest, the sages, just by seeing him, prayed to him to be his wife. He said, benediction will be granted when I come as Krishna. So the practice of Gopi Bhava is since time immemorial. But in Chaitanya Charitamrita, Mahaprabhu himself says, Ama bina anne nare braj prem dite. Mahaprabhu says, apart from me, no one else can grant this benediction. Though this Gopi Bhava was being performed, sadhana, before Mahaprabhu, but he says, other than me, no one can give. What no one can give other than him? Sakhi Bhav, Gopi Bhav was being given before him also. Mahaprabhu said only he can award that personally. Mahaprabhu is a combined jugal. Radha Shri Krishna Chaitanya, Radha Krishna Nahi Anya. Shri Krishna himself wanted to relish the rasa, the mood of Radha Bhava. But it does not have much splendor, the astonishment relative to Manjari Bhava. It is stated in Vedas that when Mahaprabhu descends and is in Radha Bhava, he relishes very high level ecstasy. But it is also read in Chaitanya Charitamrita that his joints get dismantled and stretched to unusual length. When does this happen? When he is relishing Radha Bhava, these things happen to Mahaprabhu? No. When Mahaprabhu, even after relishing Radha Bhava, when he relishes Manjari Bhava, then his joints get dismantled and stretched to unusual lengths. So the relishment of Manjari Bhava has a supreme, utmost, highest splendor for the Lord also. He himself, even after relishing Radha Bhava, relished Manjari Bhava. Advaita Acharya relished Manjari Bhava. All the Parshadas relish Manjari Bhava by Mahaprabhu's grace. It is mentioned in Sri Chaitanya Chandrodaya Natak. All this Manjari Bhava, Ekadash Bhava, they are mentioned in various scriptures like Dhyan Chandra Padati, the literature of six Goswamis, but in a very secretive form. Sometimes people think whether to have faith in this philosophy of Ekadash Bhava, the Guru gives Siddha Pranali, your 11 features, eternal features of your Swarupa, or not. People think whether to have faith or not on all this. To have faith or not is a wrong question in itself. Why? Because since the time of Mahaprabhu, when he disappeared, and from till that time up to till just 100 years back, till 450 years, all the devotees in Gaudiya Vaishnavism, they attained Siddhi only by this means of devotional service, that is, approaching a spiritual master in a particular, aspiring for a particular rasa, take the Diksha mantras, take the Siddha pranali, and achieve the desired destination, that is the Manjari Bhava. All the great saints, Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj, Gorakshadas Das Babaji Maharaj, they attained Siddhi by following and giving the Manjari Bhava Siddha Pranali. This is being done for this is being done even till now from Mahaprabhu's time. So the very question that whether I should agree to this philosophy or not is a wrong question. Actual question is whether the upcoming philosophers, maybe the more famous ones, they are right or not. Because the earlier process is valid, per, done by Siddha Jagannath Das Baba, Siddha Gorakshadas Baba, and so many other Braj saints. That was always right. And it is being practiced till now. So there is no question regarding this. We may also find in a book, Braj Ke Bhakt, that explains the lifestyles of various saints residing in Braja. The common point was the Siddha Pranali. Every saint received Siddha Pranali, that is their eternal Manjari Swarup, from the spiritual master, from unbroken disciplic succession from Mahaprabhu, which has to be 500 years old. They meditated on their own Siddha Deha, Manjari Bhava, and attained Siddhi. But in some places, it is said that in some institution, in our place, all moods, all bhavas are being given. All the bhavas are available. This in itself explains the absence of any parampara. Because parampara, the disciplic succession, means that only one bhava is there. What does parampara mean? My guru is doing what his guru is did, what and his guru did what his guru did, until the Supreme Lord. There is a continuous chain in which the same bhava is followed. This is called parampara. This is such a simple thing to understand. Parampara means of only one bhava. It is not that parampara, you are practicing Sakhi Bhava, some Guruji is practicing Das Bhava. This is not parampara. You are doing worship of Narsingh Dev, someone is doing worship of Jagannath Ji. This is not parampara. If someone says like this, then this is out of sheer ignorance. It is not as per scriptures that in our place all bhavas are available. Parampara is not a supermarket. It's not a mall. It means that only one, parampara means only one bhava is granted, given by a diksha. Sakha bhava have their own lineage. Vatsalya bhava has their own lineage. Even there is a lineage of Chandravalis. If you want to be in Chandravali's mood, if one wants to establish a relationship with Lord Rama, there are so many different bhavas, Ramananda Sampradaya. Thus, they are separate lineages and paramparas as per different moods. Parampara means the lineage to obtain a particular bhava, to attain a particular bhava. Any parampara will commence from the Lord, the Nitya Siddha Parikars, the eternal associates, render service to the Lord in one particular bhava. Are we able to understand this? Does this question, that this topic, that I am not able to understand, to accept the philosophy is right or wrong? First of all, there is only one philosophy. Rest, everything else is fiction. It is not that one can sit at ease and do some chanting of fixed rounds, do some morning program, some ritual, and do some Bhagavad Seva here and there, and someone will take you from the back door. This is fiction. This is not philosophy. Philosophy is one. Even if one does not have faith in philosophy, it does not affect the fact that philosophy is true. Like, even if one does not firmly believe that Bhagavad Dham exists, but still it exists. One does not have faith in the words of Goswamis, six Goswamis. Does not have faith in the divine words, but still the transcendental words will always remain true. Hence, if anyone says that at our place all moods, rasas are available, given, then it is simply bogus. Surely it is not a parampara. It is not philosophy. Because in any bona fide lineage, any bona fide parampara, only one mood, one rasa is being given. Parampara means it is a one bhava only. Everything else is just mere fiction. That at the time of death, someone will take you to dham, somehow or the other. You have to be some person pure. It is not so. No scripture authenticates this, validates all this. Mahaprabhu says, sadhe vastus sadhan bina kabu nahi paaye. One has to practice the required sadhana. In Braj Ke Bhakt book also, we find that the saints have, all the saints have followed the same process of sadhana bhakti. Just one process has been there for the last more than 500 years. And we all are following that process only. Nothing new ever was required to be invented. In Sanat Kumar Samhita, Lord, this Narad Muni asked Shiva, "Oh my spiritual master, you have answered so many of my queries and I am completely satisfied. But beyond all this, one more higher knowledge is there. I wish to hear that about the supreme path, the Raganuga Bhajan. Though all the questions have been answered, still one more path which is unheard, which is the highest of all, Ragmarg." Shiva answered, "O Narada, desiring for the welfare of all, you have asked a very beautiful question. The entire world will benefit from this. Although this is a secret of all secrets, most confidential knowledge, but still I will tell you. The gopis always render loving service to Sri Krishna in the mood of conjugal love, parikya bhav, and thus they relish the highest leela ras. The sadhakas should also meditate upon themselves as being a very beautiful Braj Gopi in the prime of youth, endowed with all the qualities, and they are very dear to Sri Krishna, but they never desire even in their dreams to unite with Sri Krishna physically. These sakhis are friends of Radha Rani and always engaged in her loving service. Love of Radha Rani is more important than love of Sri Krishna. In rest, all other bhavas, the profound affection towards Sri Krishna is relatively more. But in this bhavulasa rati, love for Radha Rani is more than love for Sri Krishna, the sthai bhav. In all other modes, Krishna is the prime object of service. But here, Sri Krishna himself serves Srimati Radha Rani. Why? Manjis don't desire to unite in conjugal love with Sri Krishna, because they are completely satisfied in relishing the indescribable bliss of seva ras attained by serving the divine pair Shishu Radha Madhava. Adbhut seva ras aswadana. Till one is completely satisfied, one will continue to hanker for the higher things, which can give him relatively more contentment. But manjaris are completely satisfied. Sri Krishna crosses all his limits to relish Radha Bhav. Though it is almost impossible to fully relish Radha Bhav because it is ever increasing, anything that is ever increasing cannot be limited, bound by anything. This cannot be fully relished. Sri Krishna tried to relish Radha Bhav, but was not able to fully relish it. Sri Krishna, though relishing Radha Bhav to some extent, even after that also he desired something else. What was that? He relished the supreme Manjari Bhav as Gauranga Mahaprabhu. So Manjari Bhav is the highest, the pinnacle of selflessness, the highest of all relishments. There is nothing exists beyond this Bhava. Hence it is told that Sadhak during Brahma Muhurta, throughout the day, should meditate upon Ashtakali Lila, Ratri Dine Kore Braje Krishner Sevan. Be absorbed day and night in the practice of Smaran, meditating on the various pastimes of Radha Krishna and render service to them. Narad Muni said, "Now I want to hear about Ashtakali Leela." Shiva said, "He said, I got in scriptures a practice to attain is also mentioned, but how will I accomplish it?" The statement explains that Narad Muni is actually deeply requesting to hear more about Ashtakali Leela. Without having knowledge of that Ashtakali Leela, the various services rendered therein, how will one be able to get absorbed in the seva, manasi seva? Until unless one knows the Ashtakali Leela, because service has to be rendered ratri dine. One should know what is the service in ratri, what is the service in dina, the day and night, what are the different services, so that one can really serve. How will one be able to get absorbed till one has knowledge what is Ashtakali Leelas and the services rendered therein? Thus, if any sadhaka takes shelter of and desires to attain gopi bhava, practice manasi seva, foremost need is to hear about Ashtakali Leela. Without hearing about it and meditating on Ashtakali Leela, one cannot get absorbed in manasi seva. It is neither possible to render manasi seva during day or night. Thus, hearing Ashtakali Leela is a dire necessity. In few institutions, whenever 10th canto is recited and explained in the morning Bhagavatam class, it is stopped. And the Guru himself says, no, 10th canto is not meant to be heard. Huh? Is it? We should ask, are you a genuine Gauriya Vaishnav? Few so-called acharyas clearly say that they haven't read any scripture of Six Goswamis or any Ashtakali Leela scriptures. I have come across myself. Will one gain anything from them? Huh? Ask yourself. Once a devotee from a big institution came to Radha Kunda, and before leaving, he asked the acharya of that institution, "I desire to become a manjari, meditate on manjari bhav. If you can bestow siddhi to me in this bhav, then I will not go anywhere else." The acharya replied, "Till now, I have meditated myself only a servant of Shri Krishna. So I cannot do that for you. I cannot give you siddhi in manjari bhav." And this 40 years chanting Hare Krishna. After doing so much seva, 40 years chanting Hare Krishna, if someone is not yet clear about all this, still thinks that he is servant of Krishna. I mean, he is a follower of Raktak and Patrak. But we are supposed to be followers of, we are supposed to be Rupanuga, followers of Rupa Manjari. This is a matter of great misfortune. Our Gurudev Babaji Maharaj says, though devotees have taken shelter of lotus feet of Mahaprabhu, still they don't follow him. This is a matter of great misfortune. Now the question that how will one attain Manjari Bhav is still unanswered. Manjari Bhav is beyond all Vedas. Vedas can ascend maximum to Gopi Bhava. But Manjari Bhava is beyond that. In Chaitanya Chandrodaya Natak, it is stated that Mahaprabhu, before his disappearance, met Advaita Acharya and said, "I descended at your request, but still one of my tasks is left unfinished. I wish to bestow special benediction to all those who have taken shelter and those who will be surrendering after my departure. I want to bless everyone with the indescribable relish of this Manjari Bhava." So your request for this mercy of this blessing from me, as I descended at your humble request, so I cannot refuse. Advaita Acharya replied, "Yes," and followed the same. This statement that those who have taken shelter in Mahaprabhu Sampradaya is much more grave than it normally looks. Acharyas tell us, "Ashray laya sei bhaje, tare Krishna hi taje, ar sab mare akaran." One who has taken bhajan in Mahaprabhu's ashray, in an ashray of a proper lineage, parampara from Mahaprabhu, 500-year-old parampara, Shri Krishna will never leave them. Rest, everyone will die without any reason. And Mahaprabhu told Advaita Acharya that whoever takes shelter of me, even after my departure, I will give him two swarupas, one as a Manjari in Vrindavan and one as a Kishore Brahman in Navadvipa. So what is the first step in devotional service? It is to take shelter of a bona fide lineage, parampara, and then to take shelter of a spiritual master from that parampara. This thing should be very clear from the very beginning to avoid any confusion whatsoever. Mahaprabhu said he wants to grant Manjari Bhava from this very moment to all those in my sampradaya who do bhajan, taking shelter of the sampradayas. This was a special task yet undone. So Advaita Acharya, knowing that Manjari Bhava is a pinnacle of all relishments a living entity can ever ascend to, requested for the same. And finally, by Gaur Kripa, in Chaitanya Chandrade Natak by Kavi Kanapur, it said that one gets, Mahaprabhu said one will get two swaroop. It is just like one renders services Gaur Leela and like a Jati Smar. Jati Smar means as if remembering some past life. In Gaur Leela, renders direct service to Gaurang Mahaprabhu and simultaneously he is a Manjari in Braj Leela also. Are we familiar with all this? This is sort of like a, in Gaur Leela, sort of like a dream in previous birth. There's a faint remembrance that I am a Manjari. So Gaur Leela is a Leela in Sadak Bhav, the mood of a practicing devotee, very relishing. Lots of relishment is there. And in these Gaur Parshads, when we become Gaur Parshad, we'll known as Sadak Siddha Parshads. And the mood of Braj Leela will be Siddha Siddha Parshads. So this was A to Z of Bhakti. Hope all the deep secrets and mysteries of Bhakti have been revealed to you. Hare Krishna.